Hey heathens, King Heathen here, and I find that what has always worked best for me is a combination of ignorance and intellectual dishonesty. And, you know, don't misunderestimate the power of willful ignorance. Why let a lack of understanding or so-called knowledge keep you on the sidelines of being a YouTube atheist? I mean, you don't need to know history to use it as a weapon. And which leads me to my next thing about intellectual dishonesty. You know, the Bible is a perfect way to really just make them Christians mad, because you can just quote stuff out of context and you can tell Christians that they're still under, act like they're still in the Old Testament. Stuff really just makes them mad. But seriously though, you know, don't get too hung up on facts, because you know, I can use facts to prove just about anything.
Yeah, for me, you know, it's pretty much anger. And I just think that, you know, if we're ever gonna, you know, like, wipe this religion thing off the face of the earth, that somebody's gonna have to get, you know, righteously angry. And you know, so that's what I do. And also, you know, anger is really important for getting subscribers, and then subscribers help validate your anger. So, you know, for centuries, mankind has only had ways of expressing his anger, like kicking puppies. And I just think that now with YouTube, it makes our anger a lot more stronger and effective. And I think that's what's going to win this whole fight against religion.
Okay, how should the snake pagan put this so that mere mortals can understand it? Fucking vulgarity, okay? That's what works for me. Nothing says sincerity like fucking vulgarity. And you can't just fucking drop some A-bombs like every third word. And if you don't have people wondering, like, if you have Tourette's or not, then you're a pretty fucking sorry-ass excuse for a fucking YouTube atheist, and you should get your fucking pansy ass off of YouTube, fucking asshole.
Okay, fucking, you know, addendum here. And, so, apparently, you know, I have to spell it out for you people. You know, I have all that shit going on. I'm irreverent, angry, I fucking curse, you know, all that stuff. That's not, what makes, a good YouTube atheist. You wanna fucking know what it is? Alright, I'll tell you. Here's what it is. Volume, okay? Both kinds, alright? First of all, the noise-wise kind, alright? If it's worth saying, it's worth shouting, okay? And then second of all, the amount kind of volume. And, you know, if you're not producing two or three YouTube videos a day, then you're not a fucking YouTube atheist, okay? If you've been on YouTube for a year, say, and you have less than like 650 videos, you know, I'm sorry, but that's not gonna cut it. You know, just, you know, that's the real thing. Just keep in mind, the more videos you have, the writer you are.
Hello, this is Kevin 13 with number five. And this one is ridicule. And ridicule is really the cornerstone of YouTube atheist philosophy. And no heathen should be without it. And remember, it's for most of you out there who, you know, don't have the intellect that I do, it's not about proving them wrong. It's about deflecting attention away from the fact that you are ignorant. So any kind of ridicule is acceptable. Just remember to keep it topical and offensive. And I would suggest using the word stupid as much as possible, because this automatically puts people on the defensive and gives you an air of intellectual superiority.